us be aware of one basic fact, that every avatar has a mission to fulfill. Until that mission is fulfilled, they will not leave their sojourn on earth. They, once their mission is fulfilled, they disappear. That's all. Because they have come here in human form with a mission. This is what is called Leela Janma. Janma, the birth, Leela, the divine sport. So here they come down in human form with a special mission. I repeat, the moment mission is fulfilled, they disappear. Next point is, few examples that we know. Rama came with his mission, Satya and Dharma, truth and righteousness, by demonstrating this in his own life. At the end, what happened? He just withdrew from the scene. He just withdrew from the scene. All of them, all brothers, all of them. Take for example Krishna. When once his mission of spreading prema, love, is accomplished, he just withdrew from this scene. Take for example Shirdi Baba. Shirdi Baba came here at the time to bring about a kind of brotherhood between Hindus and Muslims. And also love through his miracles and by his own personality, his compassion, his love. And after that mission is fulfilled, he has withdrawn from his body. Jesus Christ, when once his mission of sacrifice, love, dedication, service, they are fulfilled, he has decided to leave this body. He knows the day of crucifixion. He knows that all his enemies will take upon his life. He knows that he is going to be crucified. He fixes that after accomplishing his divine program. Rama, Krishna, Jesus. Do you know Buddha was poisoned? He allowed himself to be poisoned because he has accomplished his divine program. He has fulfilled his divine program. So what I want to let you know is, avatars, they come down on earth, they mingle with us freely with the divine program and will continue to be with us until their tasks are fulfilled completely. Then they disappear. Same thing happened in the case of Bhagavan Sri Sathya Sai Baba. What all we say about his mission and all that is only our cheap imagination and immaturity. Let me talk to you on this, what Baba said. Some people said, it's really very silly. Baba left his body because he felt that his body decayed, and that that body, he felt that it is useless, it will not serve him any purpose. What a foolish statement it is. Does he ever say that my body decayed? Does he ever say that his body has become useless? Not to my knowledge. Not to my knowledge. He will be hurt if he say, how are you, Swami? I remember one incident, a top doctor from America. He came and asked him, Swami, how are you? Swami said, I am fine. He asked again, how are you? Because doctor knows that Swami is not doing well. Swami said, I am fine. This doctor asked again, how are you? If you ask again, I'll send you out. After all, the body may appear to be decaying in your sight. The body might be looking useless from your point of view. But it is left to his discretion. It is left to his decision. How long to continue, that's all. The body won't dictate him. Please understand this. The decaying body will lead to the end of our lives, but not in his case. Body won't dictate him. He dictates his body. Meaning, he would withdraw when he decides. That's all. Not according to the condition of the body. Let us be aware of this. And somebody also say, it seems, he said that, what is the use of this body? Anything cannot be done. It is better to discard such a body. Would Swami say that? Swami gave up his body because of ill health to take up. This is the point. He has discarded his body to take up subtle form. There cannot be any greater sin than this. It is the worst of the crimes that we can ever commit in our life. Utter distrust in Swami. Total disregard to his teachings. So, according to you, he left his body because he's decaying. Why? To transfer to the subtle body. Is that possible? Very bad. To take up, meaning Swami himself will take the form of subtle body. That's what they said. Baba said, as I said, mentioned in the previous talk, there is no subtle body. Subtle body ends with death. Whereas the false claim that he takes the form of subtle body after leaving this, after discarding the present body. Pakka untruth, totally false. We cannot be carried away for such things. And it is also claimed that he was forced to leave his body because of ill health. And further, foolish statement, he was made to leave his body early against his will. What a dirty, stupid, idiotic statement it is. On one hand you say he is God. On one hand you say whatever he wills will happen. You say on one hand that he controls the whole thing. But now you also say that he had to leave his body quite early against his will. Does it not look rather shameful to say these things? Very sad. By just going through these statements, I felt very sad. Because we hold Baba omniscient, omnipresent, omnipotent, God, all-powerful, who controls the whole thing by his divine will. And if you say that he left his body against his will, when everything happens as per his will, how can he leave his body against his will? Is it not contradictory? Just think for yourself. In Bhagavata Vahini, his own composition, his own writing, what did Baba say? That he is the divine director, he is a puppeteer, he will make the puppets to dance. Something like the director who directs the actors how to act on the stage. He is Sutradhari. He is a Sutradhari, the divine director, the puppeteer. And then please follow this point. Swami said this in Bhagavata Vahini. His will guides and determines every single movement and gesture. He guides and directs every single movement and gesture. That's what he declared in Bhagavata Vahini. With what face you say that he left his body against his will because the body is decaying? Does it carry any meaning? That's what my question is. Again, Sathya Sai speaks, volume 37, page 23, October 17th, 2004. What does Baba say? He is the cosmic play director. Baba is the cosmic play director. He directs you. Who are you to direct him? He guides you. Who are you to guide him? Cosmic director. That's an eye-opener for all of us to know that everything happens as per his will. And I should also tell you, Sathya Sai speaks, volume 3, page 4, February 5th, 1963, my friends. 1963, very long back. What did he say? His role will be according to him, that's all. You cannot say, Swami, this is your role. Nobody can say, I imagine this role to be played by you. No, any role or any part, I take it upon myself. It will be according to me. That's what Baba said. And further, that's also. Let's not say, Swami left all of a sudden and Swami decided to leave us. He was very sick. Therefore, he had to discard his body. Wrong! Because Baba said in his discourse, every step in the career of the avatar is predetermined. Everything is preordained. Everything is predetermined. When he should appear, when he should disappear, when he should take the body, when he should withdraw from the body, they are all predetermined. The divine plan. That's what Baba said. So we cannot say it happened all of a sudden. And then I also would like to tell you how confident he was. The other name of confidence is Bhagavan Sri Sathya Sai Baba. What a confidence. See that what he said. The task will succeed. There's nothing like going back. The task for which I have come will succeed. It will not be impeded by any obstacle. It will not be impeded by any obstacle. Meaning nothing come along the way of his will. Nothing can stop him. Things will happen as he designed and as he decided. And then Swami also said, it will not be limited. It will never be slowed down. See that. He's so confident that his mission will never be slowed down. It will never stop. It will succeed. Further said, Baba said, when the Lord decides and wills, his Sankalpa cannot be hindered. That's Vajra Sankalpa. His will is as strong as diamond. Nothing can happen. It has to happen as he willed. It must happen as he decided. That's all. That's what Baba said. And Swami further said, this body has come because of divine Sankalpa, divine will. And why has he taken the human form may be the question. And this is the answer given by Baba. What did he say? He has come here to uphold the human values, Satya Dharma Shanti Prema, to bring the whole world under one canopy, the fatherhood of God and brotherhood of man, to come to the rescue of the devotees, to encourage the pious people, to put people along the right path. He has got a divine program which has got to fulfill. And he fulfilled to a great extent that we come to know slowly by and by. And then he has not left the body all of a sudden. Please understand, my friends. Because he himself said, departure was conscious exit. He knows when he should leave. Gradually he will allow his body to go. Nobody can force upon him. That's what Baba said. For your reference, I may tell you what he said? Rather, yes, that's what he said in his talks. Yes, just 1 second. Yes, Sathya Sai speaks, volume 4, page 49, December 17th, 1964. I think it's quite enough for all of us to know how he could peep into the future, how he can get into the future and warn all of us against these threats, against these possible dangers. And then, look here, my friends, there's a claim by somebody. Swami did not complete his mission, and the rest of the mission I have to fulfill, complete it. Oh, I don't know how people believe such statements. Sathya Sai speaks, volume 3, line 15, I mean page 15, July 6th, 1963. Long, long back. What did he say? Nothing can halt, nothing can stop my work as an avatar. Nobody can stop me. And further he said, in his birthday discourse, in the year 1968, that is the 43rd birthday, what did he say? This task will succeed. What I decide, what I designed, what I planned will succeed. Nobody can stop. Impossible. It will not be slowed down. That's what he declared in one of his birthday talks, year 1968, 43rd birthday. And then he also said, I am engaged in the task for which I have come. I am always engaged. Swami is very busy to fulfill the task for which he has come. What is it? To inculcate faith in the path of the highest spiritual peace. The highest spiritual peace. We don't have peace today. Let us have faith in peace. Swami has given us a way, has taught us how to live peacefully, how to live blissfully. That's what he said. And then, see that, we devotees should be charged with this saying of Swami, emphatic saying of Swami. What does he say? I shall not stop or retract a step. I shall not stop or retract a step. I will not go back. I will not step down even a single step. I will not stop in any case. That's what he declared on that day. Nobody can stop me. And then nothing agitates me. Yes. Understand that. My resolve must prevail. My task will be accomplished. My mission will succeed. That's what Baba said. What an emphatic statement it is. What a divine declaration it is. Only he could say that. Sathya Sai speaks, volume 1, page 16, September 9th, 1958. That's what he said, my friends. Let us understand it. Now I come to a different dimension. Some say he left a lot of work behind and we must complete that work. And we must complete that work very fast. We should speed up our work left over by him. And further foolishness has gone to the climax. Some says he did only 20% of his work during his lifetime, and it's our, my job to do remaining 80% of his work. The one who says is a fool, the one who believes that is a double fool. You are capable of doing 80% of work, while Avatar could accomplish only 20%. Did he say that to you? Or did he say to the public? When you openly said, I will succeed, no one can stop me, then how do you say that 80% is left over? Is there any truth in that statement? And then, it's false to say that there's a lot of work left behind for me to do. And the work has to be speeded up. And that he will do it in this so-called subtle form. That's also utterly false. And further, the climax of madness is this. That subtle form will do greater work faster than Sathya Sai Baba himself. Ah, the climax to one's own foolishness. I don't know. How can you be faster than him? Well, with what authority you would say that I will fulfill his mission? How can you do that? Therefore, in all these years of his physical form on earth, he has done far less than what this subtle form could do it. That is the claim of people. Impostors, false gurus, how do you expect such statements, having been with Swami? What should I estimate myself if I follow such words? Or how should I consider myself if I believe such words, believe such false claims? I have to blame myself. The man who claims may have his own selfish reasons, but I should have my intellect, some reason. Please, my friends, exercise the power of discrimination. Judge for yourself. Wake up. It's time to wake up. That's what we have to do. And then, further statement is, one-third of his mission is completed, two-thirds of mission is not completed. That's what I'm going to accomplish. What do you say that? Only one-third is it? Two-thirds I'm going to do in this subtle form. Did Baba say that? Please understand this, my friends. There are some books published under the title Conversations with Bhagavan Sri Sathya Sai Baba. Page 37, volume 3. He said it on 8th of August, 2001. People will say, in 3 to 4 years, we could start so many institutions. In 3 to 4 years, we could start so many hospitals. We could start so many service activities within just 3 to 4 years. Something like instant coffee, instant food. It's not like that. Sathya Sai Baba spiritual movement is slow and silent. It is a spiritual revolution. Sathya Sai mission is not merely service activities, not merely establishing institutions. His main mission is transformation of mankind. Transformation of man. To make every man realize the divinity within. Not the establishment of institutions, gathering supporters, collecting funds within a short time. I think, I don't know to what extent I'm correct. Allopathy medicines give you relief immediately. If you take paracetamol tablet, the temperature will go down. Good. Next morning it will rise. So the rapid program, the quick programs will give you only short-term gains, short-term profits. But in the long run, these gimmicks, these magics won't help. Everything should be slow. Slow and steady wins the race. Baba believes in this. Start early. He started his mission right from his childhood. drive slowly. When was Ishwarama school established? After how many years he started the college at Anantapur? After how many years he started university in Puttaparthi? After how many years he started the super speciality hospitals? How much time he has taken? He has taken pretty long time. Why? Because the projects are not for project sake. The projects are not merely for propaganda or publicity. Projects are the opportunities for the devotees to take part, to play their role in the fulfillment of the divine mission, which is slow and steady. As a young boy, he started reformation and transformation in the village. As a young boy, he started serving everybody. As he was becoming older and older, then he started establishing schools. Just estimate. All the statistics are available. When was the school established? When was the college established? When was the university established? When were the hospitals started? When was the water project started? How much time has taken? What was the gap between these projects? Why should we take long time? When you can do in 3 to 4 years, I can do. Within 4 or 5 years, I can do whole thing. It won't do. Start early. Drive slowly. Reach safely. He not only is saying, but also his mission also should be like that. He could successfully run the mission like that. Slow and silent. Slow and silent. Silent, no publicity. Slow, gradual. So gradual, silent change he brought in everybody. Not a kind of a mesmerism or anything like that. Not all of a sudden. Please understand. Baba said it clearly in that conversations with Bhagavan Sathya Sai Baba, page 37, volume 3, 8th of August, 2001. What did he say? I don't take a rapid program. I don't take any rapid program or quick programs. I don't take that. It's not like a TV campaign. That's what Swami said. All these things that you take up very fast, they give you only temporary results. I'm just quoting Swami. They give you only temporary results. The projects that could be completed within a short time will give temporary temporary results, and you may have publicity. But what if? But Swami said it. My process is slow, but the methods will be effective and permanent. The effect of Sathya Sai Baba, the steps he has taken up, will be effective and everlasting, permanent. That's why quite slow in his movement. And then it was also written, he also reported to have said, in Conversations with Sathya Sai Baba, volume 4, page 87, 1st May 2006, Swami said this. I think it was Hisla who asked him, Swami, Ramakrishna touched Vivekananda and there was immediate change in Vivekananda. Will it happen now also? This is Swami's answer. What did he say? Slowly, gradually, I bring about change in the lives of devotees, not all of a sudden. But the change I bring about is permanent. That's what he said. They understand it. Let's not expect any rapid, quick results out of that. And further, Sathya speaks, volume 1, page 31, September 29, 1960, long back. What did he say? I shall certainly achieve the purpose of the avatar. There is no nothing like dropping in the middle, nothing like not being total, not completing any task, leaving it incomplete. Then that's all our misconceived notions, foolish ideas, that he never said it. On one hand, when he says, I will complete the task, who are you to say that he has not completed the task? Who are you to say that? How foolish it is. That's what he said. I shall certainly achieve the purpose of this avatar. Don't doubt it. Some people doubt for themselves and make all of us doubting Thomases. You are already gone and you aren't also to be mad. What's all this? And further he said, I will take my own time to carry out my plan. Swami has got time. He has got his own plan. Look to ourselves. When we came to Swami, he decided. How long should we be in his fold? He decides. How devoted should be? He guides. Therefore, but he will not leave you in any case. Therefore, my friends, here I take time. But I will certainly carry out my plan. That's what Swami said. This highlight. I cannot hurry because you are hurrying. We are always in a hurry to catch the bus or to catch the train. To catch moksha also, we are in a hurry. Hurry, 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 won't do here. Swami takes his own time. He'll watch you and bring about transformation without your notice. And accomplish what he wants through you. And he will not leave you until then, as he said. And Swami said, my word will never fail. My word will never fail. It must happen as I will. All that I said must happen as I will. That's what Swami has said. Are these not enough to be convinced? Are these not adequate to be wise? Are these not enough to decide what is right, what is wrong? What is truth, what is false? Are these statements not enough? Statements made right from 1960. We don't care to read his message. We don't want to keep ourselves familiar with his teachings. That is applied today. We are simply carried away by gifts of grace. What ring he has given me, what watch has given me, and how he named my great-great-grandson, how he got my granddaughter married, that's not an endeavor. That's not his mission. They are only gifts of his grace to just pull you towards the spiritual path. You have forgotten that and you just brag about these things. It's our fault. And then, you see, please note this point. Sathya Sai speaks, Volume 1, page 31, September 29, 1960. What did he say? Avatars, avatars, leave their bodies once their mission is complete. Meaning, they don't leave until then. Sathya Sai speaks, Volume 42, page 4, February 21st, 2009. That's what he made this statement. Therefore, let us not be carried away by these falsifications or false statements. So it's totally false that he left because of his ill health. And then even Sri Ramakrishna, Paramahamsa, also lived until he completed his task. And that had happened, that's what Swami said. And again, see that Sathya Sai speaks, Volume 10, page 39, December 25th, 1970. What did he say? My body is like other bodies, is a temporary habitation. Swami's body is also as temporary as the bodies of anybody. But my power is eternal. Baba's power is eternal. All pervasive, everlasting. And as I start repeating these statements, I get charged and highly emotional, because nobody in human history made such statements. My power is eternal, all pervasive, everlasting. So you cannot say Baba left his body, I am in charge of Baba. Yes. I cannot say I am going to do what all he did before. Rather, he has entered into my body, and made me do all this. What is all this? This statement says, my body is like the body of anybody, which is temporary. But my power is eternal and everlasting, all-powerful. Then these silly points, these silly things, will never be said again by anybody. And then, after all, and he also said it, Sathya speaks, volume 42, page 5, February 23rd, 2009. What did he say? This body, or the body of an avatar, exists for certain period, and then withdraws as per their plan of action. That's what he said. When the divine Atma, embodied in the physical body, reaches its eternal abode, it is a matter of joy, not sorrow. Meaning, when I withdraw from this body, don't cry, don't feel sad that Swami left his body. There are many people who are telling, even today, Swami left his body, so what? He left his body, you are still in the body. Swami is in you. What is the question of Swami left? It's foolishness. And therefore he said, don't cry because I have withdrawn from you. And therefore, when I have gone to the source because he is everywhere, in a formless, in a nameless state, he has come down with a name and form, and then gone back to nameless, formless state. He has come from the nameless, formless state and he has gone back to the nameless, formless state. Where does it exist? All over. All over. The divinity exists all over, everywhere. But comes in a human form when he decides, when he wills. Let's understand this. Therefore, let us not say, Swami has gone, Swami has left. It has no meaning at all. Where has he come? From nature, from all the five elements, from the whole of the universe, and has been there around us, in us, above us, below us. That is the feeling that we should have, as he himself declared many times. And then he also said, avatars have some program, have some stages. Why? If you think of Rama, he has got first stage, Balakanda, and then Ayodhya Kanda, like that. Each chapter in his life, Balakanda, Ayodhya Kanda, and then comes Yudha Kanda, all these. Kanda meaning a chapter. There are four chapters in the life of Sri Ramachandra. In each chapter, his behavior, his pattern is different. I think I am clear. Therefore, every avatar has some stages. Take some Krishna. Krishna has got Krishna Leela, all of miracles. Then second part, teaching of Bhagavad Gita. Teaching of Bhagavad Gita is another chapter. Therefore, even in the life of an avatar, there are different stages. Therefore, in respect of Swami also. He said it, Sathya Sai speaks, volume 1. And what, first page, what did he say? October 18th, 1953. Wow, 1953. What did he say? I have got these steps. First 16 years. This is child sport. Child sport, divine sport. Leelas, balya leelas, full of miracles to make people happy, to make people enjoy, to make people come to him, full of miracles. There will have many people even today who enjoyed all his miracles of those days. To give, why? Joy and contentment. All his balya leelas, the divine sport during his childhood, are meant for to give us joy and contentment. And after that, 32 years, after that, 32nd year, what will happen? Spiritual instruction. My job is to give you spiritual instruction, teaching erring humanity and directing the world along the path of truth, righteousness, peace and love. Therefore, Leela state. And then comes the next state, Bodha state, the teaching process. That's what Swami has said. Let us note it. And then Swami also said, there is conversations, page 191 to 92, volume 4, conversation with Sathya Sai Baba, 1st May 2006, what did he say? Invariably, necessarily, avatar goes through certain stages. Childhood, sure. Youthful stage, quite sure. Old age, quite certain. The stages one has to go through. Avatar has no exemption. But the divine power continues all these stages. That's what he said. First 16 years, constant leelas. From 45 to 60, emphasis will be on teaching. After the age of 60, we'll directly give. After the age of 60, please note it. We'll directly give added strength to the minds of those people who are directly working with him. Swami is here to guide us, to direct us, to strengthen our minds. And he is on the job at the age of 60 from then onwards. Now he's starting a time of change. That's what Baba said. It is just as when a strong wind comes up and blows away. Wow, wonderful example he has given. When a strong wind comes and blows away, the husk, leaving only the sound kernel. The rice grains, you know, the husk will be blown by the wind, the grain will be staying there. So this is the crucial stage when the husk, the weak-minded people, the doubting Thomases, the confused minds will be blown out. But those with strength of faith, with the strength of wisdom, will stay with him forever and ever. In this, now see that, see, this statement is made in 2006. How true it is today. In these times, many devotees will fall away from Sai, leaving only those devotees whose faith is sound and solid. So all those fellows will go, but those devotees whose faith is solid and sound will stay with him. That's what Baba said. Therefore, my friends, my appeal to you all in this talk is, let us be fully assured of the divine mission. Let us never, even in the wildest of the dreams, think that he has left the body because of his weakness, and that he has not completed his mission, and there is somebody to fulfill it, and that his process is not as fast as it is somewhere else. I explain in all this why he is slow, why he left, why we should not be carried away by these masquerades or imitators or mimicry, and also could understand that all the gimmicks, the magic that we see around is only because they are possessed by evil spirits. I conclude with a prayer to Swami from the bottom of my heart that we shall never deviate from the path that he laid for all of us. May Bhagavan bless you. Thank you very much for your time.